Hi YouTube, this is Dino here with the GD review. What I'm going to do today is just explain to you how to install the winter mod for Euro Truck Simulator 2. There is a few of the fine features you need to install winter mod before you go ahead. Some people might not have a program called WinRAR. Now WinRAR is widely available on the internet. All you need to do is type in WinRAR on there. So all you do is you type in WinRAR in the search engine, use the top link, it doesn't really matter. It's rarlabs.com/download.html. So you click that link there. You basically install the 32-bit if you've got 32-bit Windows operating system or 64-bit. It does say trial on it. That's because with the purchase version, you'd have extra features on that. You still can use it. You can still extract files. Unlimited amount of times, it's just basically paying for the additional options on that, so you don't need to worry. That might come in a later tutorial on how to install that. In the meantime, just follow the standard commands for installing that. So what you need to do, first of all, is you need to download Euro Truck Simulator Winter Mod, and you use that link there to actually download that. Once you've done that, it will give you a file that looks something like that. And basically that is the file that you need to double click on to install it. But there's two files within that. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to create another. I'm going to open that up. So I'm just going to double click on that. And I bring this box over. I'm going to create a new layer on my recording system, software, whatever. So what I want is RAR. There we go. Okay. So that will basically come up with that file there, like that. So we just add the layer there. I want to remove everything else behind that layer, though. So basically, what we've got now is we've got the file here called wintermod.exe. You just double click on that. Okay, and shortly afterwards, you'll get a pop-up box come up on screen. So with the pop-up box you've got there, you can't obviously see that because it's within my screen. So let me just get rid of these boxes. So let's get rid of all these boxes and open the Windows screen again. So you've got basically all the screens are on there. So well, you've got basically this box here, which you click open. What you will have is you will have the install options. So you just follow these install options. I chose full on there, not the basic. Click agree to terms of service. And then basically what you've got is you've got the address where it would actually put the files into with the mod file. So it's your documents, Euro Truck Simulator 2 /mod. Okay. I'm going to just click thingy. It says it's installed successfully. It might install successfully very quickly for me because I've already got it installed. So technically I'm just going over the initial thing on that. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to blank all the screens up because otherwise it's going to confuse you a little bit. I'm going to start Truck Simulator up and show you the rest of the tutorial. So I'll just launch Euro Truck Simulator. So you will hear a few sounds from my screen at the moment. That's basically Euro Truck Simulator starting up. So now I'm just going to add a new layer with the game, which is Euro Truck Simulator 2. Hopefully that will come up. Yep, brilliant. So what we've got now is you've got... Okay, let me just try that again. Right, I haven't added the layer yet. There we go. Right, so on screen you can see basically your profiles. My profiles is MP Joe, which is multiplayer Joe, because obviously I've got a multiplayer version for this now. And I've got my standard character. I've installed the winter mod on both of these characters. I don't know if I'm going to keep it on there. It's a good mod, but so what you've got basically is all the mods and skins and everything that you've got installed to. You'll probably be used to this, where you have to drag the SCS files over to the mod folder, and it basically allows you to add certain skins to your vehicles and stuff like that, vehicle mods and stuff like that. So if you scroll down, Depending on how many mods you've got installed, you might have a long list. I haven't got a very long list, so I haven't got that many mods at the moment. You'll find winter mod add-ons, v1.0.scs, and winter mod v1.0.scs. You tick both of those, so they will be on ticked. You click apply, and then basically you load into your profile, and it should come up with the winter mod on the front screen. And then you've got the scrolly thing going around the back. I think I've got two mods actually on top of each other. I think you can probably do one at a time and probably get away with it pretty easily. I've got some new upgrades by the looks of it as well. Yeah, I've got a few new upgrades to add to my Volvo, which is all good. Thank you very much for tuning in today. It's been much appreciated. Hopefully the video was helpful. If it was helpful, then give me a like, a comment, and a subscribe. If it wasn't, then obviously thumbs down for me. But whatever it is, just obviously rate me fairly. Thanks very much. Bye-bye for now.